Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back again to my channel. My name is Vicky, for those of you that don't know me, and I am your favorite Aproko girl here on YouTube. Anyway guys, this video is just me coming out to talk about like two things I saw and I want to gist with you guys about it. First of all, we'll talk about Emmanuella, the child comedian, you understand, Emmanuella that made all of us laugh, that is still making all of us laugh, the off-mark angel comedy. And then the next one we are going to be talking about, or the second one we'll talk about, is Mr. Jollof. Okay, Mr. Jollof, I'll be putting the video of Mr. Jollof maybe at the end of this video, so that I don't bore you guys out and, you know, or make my talking too long. Actually, Mr. Jollof came out and was talking about, just to talk about how ladies, you know, they stay for house again, then they use mental health as excuse, or then they use, like, they've given themselves excuse why they shouldn't stay in marriages, you understand. And for me, I feel like, I don't think that he really thought about it before making that thing. Yes, the bottom line of his conversation, or of his whatever he was talking about, was that the rate of divorce is very, very high. And to be very honest, he made it sound as if the rate of divorce being high is caused by the ladies not being able to endure or take bullshit from the men any longer. And I feel like our men, they need to step up, because they feel like, because he kept mentioning things like their mother those days, and their mother, like talking about the mothers of those days. And I'm like, women these days, they don't take bullshit anymore, you understand. They don't even endure, you understand, because I felt like our mothers, our grandmothers, take a lot of bullshit from men, that therefore making these men, you know, act the way they want or do the way they want. Right now I'm not sounding like a feminist, but I just feel like he just sounded, it didn't really sit well with me the way he sounded, you understand, about how men, how prick now the hungry men with the hungry women, now make them stay for husband house again, then they go do bomb bomb because they see single girls doing bomb bomb, they go to do bomb bomb, that when you do a bomb bomb, your husband will still be carrying women. What makes you feel that, as in I feel like, what makes you feel that every woman that goes out to do a liposuction or work on their body is because of men? Some people just do it to feel some sense of confidence, you understand, because this whole low self-esteem thing is very real, you understand. And some people go to satisfy their own self. Yes, most people go just to look good in the eyes of others, but I feel like there are people out there that go for this liposuction or body contour or whatever, that go to do that solely for their own self, to make themselves happy. So I felt like Mr. Jollof, what he was spewing or what he was saying, actually it really does sit well, because he's beginning to make it sound as if it's the whole fault of the ladies, waka waka did their leg and they want to follow men, that is why they can't tolerate the men anymore, the women cannot tolerate him. I don't understand. Can't the men step up their game and mind how they do things with ladies, you understand? Because at the end of the day, this relationship is a two-way thing, you understand. That a marriage did not work is not a fault of the man or the fault of the woman, it is both their fault, no matter what it is, you understand. Because I feel like marriage is a conscious effort from both parties. They made up their mind to make it work, because it's not like you're seeing this other person being lovey-dovey, that oh, it's so perfect with them. No, I feel like everybody that their marriage is enjoyable and is sweet or looks sweet is a conscious effort. That's how I feel. So I really do not get, or I really do not sit down with me, but I'll allow you guys to listen to it so you drop your comment. And then the second one I want to talk about is the rumor that was going about the child comedian Emmanuella. That is just, I think that girl should not be up to 12 or more than 12. She's between 11 or 12 years that she was pregnant. Everybody was just talking about it. So I think she made a post, was it yesterday or today, and a guy actually dropped a comment where I can't see the belly or something like that. He dropped the comment. I'm going to keep it on the screen for you to see. I can't see the belly. And then she also replied that obviously she is not pregnant. You understand, according to the rumor that they are saying. But I don't understand how people come up with such rumor. I don't understand, because there are things you say that can destroy people psychologically, mentally, and otherwise. And I feel like we should all curtail with the way we send these rumors out. I don't know how the rumor started. I don't know what whoever started the rumor, what the person wanted to gain, or I don't know how it got circulated like that. But anyway, Emmanuella has actually come out and has denied the claims of she being pregnant, or has discarded that claims, you understand, has said that she is not pregnant, because it was like a video clip she posted and the person was like, I didn't see the pregnancy. So I feel like that rumor, it wasn't so nice. Anyway guys, she has actually come out and she has because people were really going to her page leaving comments of, you're pregnant. You know how Nigerians can be, when they hear news they throw you, like they throw you literally. They come to your page, they went to Mark Angel's page, they were dropping comments trying to, you know, but none of them came out to like deny or discard the claim until this moment where Emmanuella actually denied. So I just felt like that case is closed now. Emmanuella is not pregnant, so make all of us rest, because the problem, the begin, like the talk was just too much. Anyway guys, let me leave the Mr. Jollof's video for you guys. So after watching, you drop your comments. I'll see you guys in my next one. Please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe if you haven't. I love you guys. See you guys in my next video.
Many of all these modern women, they don't want their ass again. That is the gospel truth. Many don't want their ass again. They want you to use mental health to come off for marriage. They don't born one or two children. They okay with the baby mama level. They fuck the worker. Not true. Now they happen now. But notwithstanding, some women, they suffer from abuse for marriage. And if you just raise your hand, knock woman, my own ideology, as you don't knock the woman, maybe the woman you come out the marriage, because the day you go raise your hand, knock you, you can't look at her love, the next day go kill you. That is just the gospel truth. But so they're not, they knock them, nothing, they're not, they beat them. Now they remove the problem for the marriage. You know? When they don't tire, many married women now they go do yashan. I don't know the matter. Many married women now, so first of all, on a complex issue, they worry some of them. Because they still say their husband now, they carry all the girls when they do yash now. They won't go do yash too. Even as you do the yash, your husband still carry the girl when the yash still beat past your yash. He like you do yash, do breast, do lip. Eh? Man won't want the ass, but the ass. Some of all these married women, as you see them now, so many of them, when they did now, so you see this, many not even breast again now. Now mental health, they go put for front. They help mental health, of course. They won't protect their mental health. And what you do? So you see married woman, so married woman, they go doing a shrink, you come Instagram called the twerk. Who you they twerk for? No, who you they twerk for now? Because this talk, eh? We need to just talk at me the common ground. Your husband never get work. Yeah, they just drop your husband for work, you never reach 1 year or 2 years, you know feel beer. You don't talk to the man in here. The next thing, you don't talk mental health. Mental health, so you're not caught to suffer. You're not caught to this, so you're not caught to that. That's what it be. These are the problems.